Hey everyone, welcome back to another Exos Heroes video. So in today's video, we're going to discuss the choreverse of FC Bernadette. So Melting Ice Bernadette and her exclusive weapon. But before that, if you wanted updated Exos Heroes content, please hit the subscribe button down below. Okay, so here we are at the choreverse chance notice. Melting Ice Bernadette recruit. So after the maintenance tomorrow up till May 10th, you can recruit plus Fate Core with higher probability than premium recruit. So this Bernadette is a parallel world, and more or less, actually, if you weren't guys around last year for the Summer Festa, they were released around, I think, August last year. And they were actually a big hit in terms of, you know, in terms of summons week after week. I think we had six, and Bernadette was one of them. If you can see, for me, with all of the Summer Festa units that were out, she had the best artwork of all, especially in her 3D model, as you will see later when I move to that one. But before that, I'll give you a small background about FC Bernadette. Bernadette was one of the first faded heroes that was widely used. She had a very good kit, cost effective in terms of mana, and she is actually good with mana as well. That is why she was very good. I was able to use her, only her fated, when I started. I was able to use her fate core, but again, I had other units already available better than her. So more or less, what they did with her Fate Core was a bit... It was good. It was... Summer's Blessing was actually also anti her. Her usage was brought down. Okay. So, as you can see here with her passive is still the same. So, increase attack based on ally's mana count, which is good. Gain 1 mana if ally mana count is at 10 or more on own turn. And gains mana if any enemy mana count is at 10 or more on own turn. So very good again in terms of increasing attack. She is actually very good. While she is not usually commonly used in PvP as of the moment, she is actually good in the dragon. So increase the damage dealt to dragons with the dragon scale of order by 250%. And overtime effect decreases the enhanced dragon fang infest effect used by the frost element dragon on of order by 20%. Okay, she is also a head dragon knight, so decreases damage from raging breath by 50%. Increases damage reduction effect for allies with dragon knight blessing by additional 20%. Can stack with another head dragon knight effect. So again, whether you're not using her in PvP or PvP tag, she is actually very good in the dragon or the holy dragon ground. Okay, and she is actually good in all in some areas of PvP as well. Okay, we'll take a look at her previous improvement in terms of FC passive. Flap if the caster has removable buff, recovery positive effect. Applied each via attack afflicts target modification for 3 turns. So again, I really enjoy this one in terms of stalling opponents, especially if you play PvP on manual. This actually applies to her as well. I use this actually for FC Iris. Next is you have your Summer's Blessing. When the battle starts, grants frost damage, one immunity one time to all allies, can't be stacked. Increases the attack by 50% for 9 turns when the frost damage immunity effect is removed. So while this was beneficial as a defensive passive for her, this actually nerfed her in a way, because again, this is anti her because she does frost damage. But as you can see here, the one that they added recently is called Sparkling Water. So increases attack of all allies by 10% for 1 round and at the start of the round. Okay, I'll go back to that later. I'll show you her S1 first. It's still the same. Summer Frost Fang deals 300% damage to one enemy, and her S2 is still the same. A 3 burst spell, 178% damage to all enemies. Summer Genius Frost Witch. Okay, let's go back to Sparkling Water. Let's look at this objectively. Okay, So this one, whether you put her in a North Von Frosty team or not, this is actually going to be okay. This is going to be good. She can probably be viable in PvP tag now. She can be good because of the 10% is 10%. Whether she's Frost that she cannot sometimes deal damage because of the opposing Summer's Blessing, but again, the 10% every round is very good. Can't ignore that. If you splash her with other heroes, with other nations, I think she would be good. But definitely, she would be shine together with North Von Frosty heroes. She is actually from North Von Frosty, and I think that based on my experience, even if I used Valentina and Shufraken, sometimes if I render the enemies, without mana, sometimes it's not enough to kill them. In a way that they actually sometimes recoup and they find a way to still kill you because they're too tough. I think North Von Frosty as a nation really needs this because again it gives a 10% damage for one round at the start of the round. Sorry, 10% attack increase attack with 10%. Every round that she's in battle. So take note, she has to be there, she has to be present, otherwise if she dies, the whole other allies won't be able to get this. So more or less, I am actually for this one. There is one team comp that comes to mind that can be, she can substitute, namely actually Bathory. So basically you can swap her out with Bathory if you don't have Bathory in North Von Frosty. So you have their Shufraken, you have Valentina. You can actually put their Tantalo, Dorca, and you can put their Bernadette or FC Bernadette. So that is actually an option for you guys if you don't have Bathory in play, or if you don't have Bathory as her SFC. And also you can actually get her at a 0.7 chance recruitment mileage, 19 core mileages for you to get her for free. And more or less, guys, let's go first to the exclusive weapon. I don't think she is actually going to it's viable to get her exclusive weapon. She's not a main character in terms of your PvP. That is why I'd forgo this. This actually is just for me a waste of Zest. I'll go back to you summoning for her. Okay, for those who have her already, I suggest that you build her up, try her. I think again, it's a mistake to ignore her giving a 10% attack bonus or increase attack of 10% per round. It's actually stupid to ignore this one. For those who doesn't have her, okay. At this point, I do not recommend pulling for her. Since we're expecting a gold Fate Core banner to drop next Thursday probably, or probably another blue Fate Core, which is Rera. But again, she's not core meta in terms of hero. She might be used in PvP now, PvP tag that is, but again, you can still get her not from her banner. You can get her from other random Fate Core tickets. She's actually viable now, and now we have shards for Fate Core. So if you like her and if you want to build her, then be my guest. But again, it's a no for me for pulling at this point. If you have her, I advise that you build her. So that's it. Okay, so let's take a look at her 3D model. Again, artwork, very, very good. Very good swimsuit. Like the design. Very cool for her. Again, she's Frost, so very good. The backside is actually good as well. I'd like to... She has the best swimsuit actually in the bunch. Hands down. I tell you. Best swimsuit in Summer's... Or Summer Festa. So best swimsuit released hands down. Okay? So anyway, guys, if you have any comments, suggestions, please put them down in the comment section below. For those who have not subscribed yet to my channel, please do. Around 85% of my viewers have not subscribed yet. So this helps my channel a lot. Anyway, guys, stay safe. Take care. This is The Warden, and I'm out of here.